the man. I grew up in Alaska, and I worked construction. I built houses and was a carpenter up there. And I guess I was making plenty of money doing that. And I don't know, I was just playing music on the side, and some of my friends just heard some stuff that I recorded myself. And they asked me to come down and sing for their band, the guitar band. And I went down there to do that and realized that you don't make any money playing music. And it was really refreshing. Like, it was really nice. I'd always grown up with money, and I spent like 7 or 8 years without money at all. So it's cool.
I didn't make music for the same reason a lot of people made music. I made music because I love music and because I was a kid with a dream in my bedroom. And inevitably, I decided that had to be some way I could make more money than most people in the music business.
I don't even consider it lucky, because we paid so much fucked up dues with Vinnie Vincent. We paid so much fucked up dues before. So I'm going now on 29 years of making millions in the music business.
I don't mind it. I do it.
How do I feel? I feel the guys that started LimeWire are geniuses, because they outsmarted everybody that represented the music that I recorded honestly and fairly. And they beat the system, because for the $200,000 worth of downloads they stole, they want to settle for $5,000. So
don't forget that.
I should be in that business.
I think it's affected the way we listen to music in a negative way, and that's the part of me that wants people to buy records. It's not really about money as much as it is about, like, the music meaning something to you and supporting the bands that you like. It was like 4 years of touring and sleeping in a van, and I guess 2 years before that, really, really not making anything either. It just takes a lot of work. It's just like any small business. I think that's probably the best thing to compare it to. You have to have like a plan, and you have to suffer through some hard times for it to work out.
I've diversified. Music sufficed a certain portion of my life, and real estate was beautiful to me.
So you have a day job.
I have a night job. You talk to a young person and you say, what do you want? A record deal. But do you even know what that is? It's an interest-free loan.
Somewhat good at what you do and creative and think outside of the box, and it's not just about money. You know, and I think everybody realizes it the second they get in their van and do their first tour and come home with nothing.
For me, 28 years later, I'm still doing the same thing I've always done. And you have to believe in yourself and have an honest talent and do what you say you do. Don't lie. And that's the best advice I can give anybody. If you think you're good at what you do, believe in what you do.
the wind.